In this lesson, we'll discuss how to solve one nonlinear algebraic equation using the bisection method. In a previous lesson, we discussed how the incremental search method can be used to find a root. For example, if we want to find the root of x cubed minus 0.3, we can increase x using a constant step size until the function changes sign. When this occurs, we have bracketed the root between two values. For a step size of 0.2, the root lies between 0.6 and 0.8. The bisection method also uses this bracketing concept. We again want to find the root of x cubed minus 0.3. We start with two values of x that bracket the root. The left bound is called xa and has the value of 0, and the right bound is called xb and has the value of 1. Our initial choice of xa and xb could be anything, as long as the root exists between them. The function evaluated at xa is negative 0.3, and the function evaluated at xb is positive 0.7. Since the function changes sign between these two values of x, we know the root exists between 0 and 1. Now we calculate the value of x at the midpoint, which we will call xmid. xmid has a value of 0.5, and the function at that point is negative 0.175. Since the function does not change sign between x equals 0 and x equals 0.5, we know there is no root in that half of the interval and can discard it. So our new interval is 0.5 to 1. The value of xa is now 0.5, and the value of xb remains 1. We calculate the midpoint between 0.5 and 1, which is 0.75, and assign it to xmid. Then calculate the function at xmid, which is approximately positive 0.122. Since the sign of the function changes between xa and xmid, we can discard the right half of the interval. The new interval is 0.5 to 0.75. The value of xb becomes 0.75, and the value of xa remains 0.5. We calculate xmid, which is 0.625, as well as the function at xmid, which is approximately negative 0.056. Since the sign of the function does not change between xa and xmid, we know the root must lie between x equals 0.625 and x equals 0.75, and we can discard the left half of the interval. We continue this process and reduce the range of possible root values until we reach a desired accuracy. There are a couple possible criteria for terminating the algorithm. First, you can stop the algorithm when the percent difference between successive midpoint estimates is below a small value of epsilon, which is the value set by the user. The percent difference is equal to the midpoint value of the current iteration minus the midpoint value of the previous iteration divided by the midpoint value of the current iteration, and we take the absolute value of the entire quantity. Alternatively, you can terminate the algorithm when the range of possible root values has dropped below a small value of epsilon, that is when xb minus xa is less than epsilon. Keep in mind that due to rounding errors, it is not possible to determine the root to infinite precision. However, for most engineering applications, you will not need to know the root beyond a few significant digits of accuracy anyways. The computational time required for the bisection method is related to the value of epsilon. As epsilon decreases, you get a more accurate estimate of the root, but the amount of computational time increases. The first advantage of using the bisection method is that, since the root is bracketed, we are guaranteed to find an estimate of the root. Additionally, the bisection method converges to a solution much faster than the incremental search method. The disadvantages of the bisection method are that it requires us to select an initial interval in which the root exists, and the bisection method is slower than other methods, which will be discussed in subsequent lessons, such as the Newton-Raphson method and secant method. Both of those methods do not bracket the solution and are called open methods.